Hey everyone, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. My name is Cordell Felix, and on this video I will show you how to extrude a circle from any surface. We will be using the loop tool found in the graphite modeling tools. This technique will help you understand how to inset and extrude a clean circle from a surface without any weird deformation on that surface. It is mainly used for high-poly modeling to get into some shapes that are rather difficult to do. I will be using these three shapes here to demonstrate how I would approach extruding a circle in and out on each surface. We have this sphere with some tubes extruding out and some in. This sphere demonstrates the difference between a 6 vertice and a 4 vertice extrude with a turbo smooth modifier applied on top of it. This is a 4 vertice extrude and this would be a 6 vertice extrude. You can see that this one is a lot smoother and this one will need more iterations to make it smoother. This box will show that we will need support edges to keep the shape of it and the sharp corners while getting that extruded circle in there. Let me remove this turbo smooth modifier on here to show that we have the support edges and we have the inset, and here's the circle. This shape is similar to the box, but I will be approaching the circle inset differently because I will be referencing a different cylinder mesh to snap to its vertices using the snap tool. The snap tool you can find up here. If you tap S, it'll show you where it is, and if you right-click it, you can choose what kind of snaps you want. I will be using vertices for this because I will be using the different cylinder mesh to snap to its vertices so that I can get this circular shape here. If I remove this turbo smooth modifier, you can see that I have the support edges here still, and I have this inset, which has these extra support loops in here to get that shape. Let's start with a sphere here where I will be demonstrating how to do a 4 vertice and a 6 vertice inset circle. So I'm going to start with the 4 vertice one. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to inset. Now I inset because I want to get that support edge to have some more control when I apply the turbo smooth modifier. So now that I have the inset, I'm going to delete this. And then I'm going to hold shift and bring this down. And then I'm going to do it again, and one more time. I'm getting the support edges in here. I'm going to switch to scale and then hold shift and scale in to get another support edge. And I'm just going to cap that off. If you right click, click cap. Now if I turbo smooth this, it's going to look okay, but it's not a perfectly round circle here. And also I need a bunch of iterations to actually make it look smooth because it's only working with 4 vertices here. So it's going to take more than 2 to look kind of smooth, and that kind of result, I just don't like that much. So if I do it with a 6 vertice, now I'm going to switch back to Edible Poly, and if I want 6 vertices, I'm going to have to delete 4 squares. So now if I inset from here, you always got to inset first, because that way we can have that support edge. Now if I delete this, and select the border by hitting 3, and I'm going to click this edge now, and it should select the entire border. So once I have the border selected, I'm gonna hit 2 and it's gonna switch to edge mode here. So with the edge mode, I can use the loop tools. The loop tools is found underneath the graphite modeling tools here, and you go to loops and click this loop tools here with a hammer and wrench, and it should bring up this little menu. So now with the border selected, you can click circle, and that'll give us the circular shape that we can extrude from. So I want to do one more inset here by going to the scale and then insetting one more circle. Now I can extrude from here. So I'm going to hold shift and go along the y-axis to do a support edge and do one more and scale one in. And then I'm going to cap that off by going to border mode, right click cap. So now if I turbo smooth this, we should get the results we want pretty quickly in under just 2 iterations. You can see that we have a lot more control with 6 vertices rather than 4 vertices. And this shape here isn't very circular. You can see it still kind of has its box shape here, and this is a lot more round. Let's move on to this box shape now, where I'll be insetting a 6 vertice circle here. And first I need to get those extra vertices in there. So I want to use the swift loop tool to add in a connected edge here and across here. So I'm going to go to edge mode by pressing 2, and then go to edit, and then swift loop. And I'm going to add one right in the middle and right across here. So with that, I can inset these four and get the 6 vertices I want. But before I go into that, I'm going to be adding some support edges so that way I can keep the shape of the square. And I have my swift loop hotkey to control shift X. You can keep going to edit and then swift loop and just add all the edges you want. I'm going to hit my hotkey. So I'm going to add support edge here, 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 and there, and one at the bottom here, and one over here. And that should be about it. So now I'm ready to insert that circle. So I'm going to select these four squares here, and then inset it just once. And then now I'm going to delete these four squares, and then I'm going to hit border mode, and then hit 2 to go to edge mode. You can switch between the two. Once you select the border, you can switch to the edges because it already has those edges selected, so it transfers just nicely. Now I'm going to go to the loops, loop tools, and circle. And I'm just going to scale that in just a bit. And that's okay. So now I can do that. I'm going to do one more inset for the support edge. And now I can put this in. Support edge, out, support edge, scale in, scale in one more time, and then cap. Oh, got to hit border mode for cap. There we go. So now if I turbo smooth this, it should look like that. There we go. For this one, I'm going to be modeling a cylinder right on its surface so I can use its vertices to snap to for when I inset this 6 vertices circle here. This is another way to get that circle shape instead of using the loop tools. This way is a little slower, but I find myself needing to use it when the circle loop tool just doesn't do the job. I'm going to close this loop tool here now. So now to start, I'm going to be going to front mode and then hitting F3 for wireframe mode. And I'm going to model in that cylinder while turning on auto grid. With auto grid, it should be on the front surface here. So I'm going to model in the cylinder and do one more click so that way it's out there. And it should be six-sided. And now if I go into perspective mode and then press F3 to go back into shaded mode, and I'm going to right-click, convert to Evo Poly, and then delete these faces except for this back one. So I'm going to select this front face here and hit Grow and then delete. So that way I have that there. This sort of acts as like a template because I have those 6 vertices there now. So now I want to add a swift loop here. That way I can have those 6 vertices. So let's go back to that model and then add a swift loop in there. And I'm just going to do one for these two vertices here and there. Again, you can do edit swift loop to add in that swift loop. So before I inset, I wanted to do the support edges. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And that's about it. Okay. So now that I have the support edges, I want to... Oh, I missed one. So now that I have the support edges, I want to inset right here. And you see that I have 6 vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm going to kind of align it to where the cylinder is. Okay, and then I'm going to delete those. Now if I go to front mode, I can use these vertices to use the snap. And I have the vertice mode snapped on. So now let's turn it on and snap them to these vertices. Just drag them to where the vertice is and it should bring it right to it on the exact location. And there we go. So now I can delete this guy. Go back to this border, and I want to do another inset just to be safe for that support, and then extrude out by holding shift, do one more, one more, and then do one in for the cap. Go to border mode, and then cap. Let's throw turbo smooth on there, and there we go. And that's about it for this quick tip. My name is Cordell Felix, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com.